Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. This video is my second featuring ChatGPT. My first was some months ago and covered organic chemistry. Now I want to throw some math-based Gen Chem questions to ChatGPT and see what happens. So here are 12 stoichiometry-centric questions posed to ChatGPT. In my video on organic chemistry and ChatGPT, I found ChatGPT to be a bit lacking. Organic chemistry is not terribly difficult, but it does have nuances. For example, is methoxide a good nucleophile? Well, it depends on the electrophile. So, in short, I found ChatGPT in its current form to be wanting. And in terms of academia, I did not see ChatGPT as a great academic integrity risk. For general chemistry, however, things are a little bit different. I feel that Gen Chem lends itself more to be concisely expressed. And the math foundation of Gen Chem, or much of Gen Chem, makes it more within the reach of ChatGPT. So here goes. Let's see how ChatGPT handles some relatively straightforward math-centric problems that might be encountered in an early Gen Chem course. First question. How many moles of carbon are in 50 grams of carbon? Below is the full response as a screenshot. ChatGPT does a great job walking through all the steps. The answer is correct, 4.16 moles. I did not give any instructions about sig figs, but the process of breaking down the question is right on the money. Units for each step of the calculation are clear. It's a good answer. Let's try something just a bit harder. How many moles of ethanol are in 50 grams of ethanol? This is not much harder, but it does involve an additional step. I did not include the full output on the screen because it won't all fit. ChatGPT correctly identifies the need to calculate the molar mass of ethanol, which it does. It even finishes the answer by responding in a complete sentence. Pretty impressive. I'm emphasizing the steps here. The full response from ChatGPT was 169 words. How many moles of ethanol are in 50 milliliters of ethanol? Again, just a bit more difficult based on starting with a volume instead of a mass. There is one more step determining the mass of ethanol in 50 milliliters of ethanol based on the density. ChatGPT did not make any mention of the temperature dependence of density, but neither would I if I did this calculation. The answer was a little shorter in word count because ChatGPT referred back to the previous answer for part of the calculation. How many moles of ethanol are in a bottle of vodka? There are some gaps in this question that ChatGPT needs to fill, and it did a great job. What is the ethanol content of vodka? ChatGPT looked that up. What is a bottle? That is not an SI-approved dimension. ChatGPT filled in the blanks. From there, the calculation looks much like the previous one. Note that the answer clearly includes the assumptions that ChatGPT used in the calculation. The answer required a total of 228 words. At this point, I have to admit that I was impressed. These are not hard questions, but ChatGPT certainly completed them far faster than I would have. How much oxygen is needed to burn 100 grams of ethanol? For this question, ChatGPT needed to construct the combustion reaction, and it must be balanced. It needed to determine the number of moles of ethanol in 100 grams of ethanol. It needed then to determine the number of moles. When I wrote the question, I was thinking about getting the answer in liters or something like that, but I forgot to specify, and ChatGPT answered in moles, which is fine. Okay, all is good. Next question. What volume of CO2 is formed when 10 grams of glucose are burned? Again, ChatGPT navigated all the steps. Balance the equation, determine the number of moles of glucose, figure out how much CO2, and convert to a volume. I did not specify the temperature or pressure of the gas, so ChatGPT assumed everything is at STP. That's fine. Here is a twist on the previous question. How much energy is released when 10 grams of glucose are burned? So ChatGPT went through all the steps. 10 grams of glucose is around 0.05 moles. The heat of combustion is minus 2800 kilojoules per mole, and the released energy is minus 154 kilojoules. And ChatGPT mentions the importance of the mathematical sign. Another winner. Next question. How much ferric chloride is formed from the reaction of 1 gram of iron metal with 5 grams of chlorine gas? So this is a limiting reagent problem. ChatGPT works the problem just fine and determines the answer. ChatGPT calculated the final amount in terms of grams, which is what I wanted, though giving an answer in moles would have fulfilled my question as well. How many grams of sodium acetate are required to make 1 liter of a half molar solution of sodium acetate? Again, ChatGPT sailed through the problem, and I was getting very impressed. I was also worried that I wasn't going to be able to stump ChatGPT in these questions. I understand that these are not sophisticated questions or calculations. Still, ChatGPT is fast. I make solutions in lab fairly often. It would likely be faster for me to put the instructions into ChatGPT, do a quick quality check on the response, and let ChatGPT do the calculations for me. I don't want to lose my chemistry membership card, but like they say, work smarter, not harder. So what is next? What is the pH of a solution of 2 grams of sodium hydroxide in 1 liter of water? Again, ChatGPT worked through the question in a logical manner, first determining pOH and then converting to a pH for a final answer of 12.71. ChatGPT is not factoring in significant figures, but that's okay for this discussion. ChatGPT did fine with a strong base like sodium hydroxide. How about a weak base? What is the pH of a solution containing 10 grams of baking soda in 500 milliliters of water? This question posed a problem for ChatGPT. The final answer is shown. The pH is way too high for a weak base like baking soda, which ChatGPT did identify as sodium bicarbonate. What went wrong? Well, here is an equation that ChatGPT generated. Yes, the symbols are not all right, but the basic ideas are present. Sodium bicarbonate dissolves in water. The bicarbonate can then react with water to form carbonic acid, which is written incorrectly, and hydroxide. The issue is that ChatGPT indicated that this last step runs to completion. So the approximately 0.12 moles of sodium bicarbonate form 0.12 moles of hydroxide. The idea of a weak base did not register for ChatGPT, so the solution was calculated as being too basic, and the solution pH was too high, over 13, instead of something in the 8 to 9 range. I did try to clue ChatGPT into the importance of weak basicity by including weak base in the prompt, but ChatGPT came up with the same final answer. Okay, so ChatGPT is not perfect. Problems with more complex equilibria might be a bit outside of ChatGPT's grasp at this time. Final question. What volume of methane gas would need to be burned to warm an Olympic-sized swimming pool from 20 to 25 degrees Celsius? I wanted something with more steps, and this question does have more steps. The answer of just 1.6 liters of methane is way too low. Okay, what went wrong? The first issue is a unit conversion problem. Everything was fine until ChatGPT tried to do a specific heat calculation. ChatGPT kept the amount of water in kilograms, but used grams in the specific heat. The necessary energy is off by a factor of 1,000, so we need 52 billion joules. Unfortunately, that is not the only mistake. There is another unit conversion issue. Here is our 52 million joules, which should be 52,000 megajoules. On the other side of the equation, ChatGPT is converting everything to joules instead of megajoules. So this factor is off a millionfold. That means our amount of methane is actually now off by a factor of a billion. For full disclosure, I haven't gone through this full calculation to determine the correct answer. ChatGPT, however, is quite low at just 1.6 liters of methane. And just a quick examination of the calculation reveals likely a billionfold error. Everything else looks okay at first glance. So, like many students, ChatGPT also wrestles with unit conversions. That's interesting. I admit that ChatGPT did a great job overall with these questions. ChatGPT, even in its early state, has some real utility in these types of calculations. I can see that students might use it to do homework or even answer test questions. I also read that Chegg, which some people feel is a site that is not used ethically by students, I read that Chegg's business model is threatened by ChatGPT. I agree with that assessment. So while ChatGPT needs to hit the books in organic chemistry, in my opinion, it performs fairly well at an introductory Gen Chem level. I hope you enjoyed this video and how ChatGPT handled a range of introductory Gen Chem questions. Please make a comment, leave a like, or subscribe to the channel. Take care.